Hello, Internet. Rumbutt here. And, finally gonna finish off the DLC. Finally gonna go and, kill the Orphan of Kos. Or, try to. We'll see. I've decided to finalize my outfit. This is the true Rumbutt outfit. My true fashion born. Gascoigne's cap, Maria's garb and trousers, and the executioner's gauntlets. Alright, let's fucking do this. I expect this to go super well. One second, let me check something real quick. I want to check this. Because I don't want to waste a bunch of poison knives. But if I can use them, I want to use them. Alright, infinite resist to poison. You know, that's one of the things that I really don't like in Bloodborne. Poison is going to be most useful for a player. In PvE, poison is going to be most useful for a player against bosses. And most of the bosses in Bloodborne are straight up immune to poison, completely. And that's just a fact, and it's kind of disappointing. Like what the hell? Like, you completely eliminate the usefulness of one aspect and one tactic of the game if every single, or nearly every single boss is immune to poison. There are a scant few exceptions to that. There are a scant few exceptions to that immunity to poison. For example, Mirago's Wet Nurse. But for the most part, the bosses are completely immune to poison. Which is, I think it's dumb. Alright, so, Orphan of Kos, round numero dos. Let's do this. Get some parry time again. I know he can be parried. Try to get all the parries I can in. Just to make it easier later. Can I check something? Nope. Okay. So you can't recover health from these, they're not even enemies, they're just, yeah. It's sad. They're just worshippers or whatever. Alright, buddy. Yeah! get these parry timing down. Considering the fact that I knew I was gonna die. See, because right now, I'm not even seriously fighting this boss. I'm practicing. I'm practicing to figure out timings and stuff. Which is why I'm trying to avoid using resources. In fact, I'm only going to shoot these 5 bullets, and then I'm going to just dodge. Come on, buddy. Bullet. Come on. Give me a parry. Yeah, gonna use blood bullets to try to figure out the parry timing and gonna do no heals. And that way, I can figure the things out and not have to farm. Because I don't want to farm. Doing research. Okay, they're really fragile. Just rolling through the kills. That's really sad. That's super fucked up. Hey, buddy. Doing right now is I'm just forcing myself to get good, because I'm honestly giving myself quite the handicap here. Like, why use resources on a boss until you've gotten good? This is a much better tactic. Of course, this only applies to a game like Bloodborne. Once we got Dark Souls 3, Dark Souls 3 is going to be like this, because there's going to be Estus flasks, you know? Admittedly, like, expendable resources, like your usables, are going to be a different story, but it's going to be Estus flasks that heal both mana and health, so, like, why use those? If I start doing really good, I'm gonna fucking start actually using. Okay, I'm starting to get the hang of this. Ow. Yeah! See, I only used one bullet and one blood vial there. And now back to research. See, the moment I started to go in on him... I choked. Like, the moment I decided, alright, and I used a blood vial, that's when I choked. The moment I started being willing to heal. Tactic for this fight is going to be, I want to parry through the first phase. That's what I want to do. I want to parry through the first phase. And in order to do that, I need to learn the parry time. And then once I get through the first phase, bullets don't matter because I'll go to dual wield. But the first phase I want to parry through, if I can. So yeah, just practicing trying to get the parry time again. See, in all these attempts, I haven't used anything. I have not used anything. Not one thing has been used. Damn, Mr. Opost. I'm also gonna see if I can't nail some backstabs on him as well, because there are certain points at which he pauses, and it would be fairly easy to score a backstab. Man, that one run. As soon as I started healing, I shouldn't have used any resources until second phase. But you know, whatever. I was doing really good. Got him down to half health with only one bullet and one blood vial used. Like, that's nuts. Am I doing it this way because I fucking summoned for Lawrence? Maybe. I feel bad about Lawrence and I feel bad about Ludwig. Like, I should have soaked. But I just got so frustrated, man. I got so frustrated. Like, when I first played the game, like, Rom kicked my ass seriously hard my first playthrough. hole just happened. Yeah, ROM seriously beat my ass my first playthrough. It took me 5 hours to beat ROM. 5 whole hours. It was ridiculous. Shit. There we go. Almost forgot. Okay, admittedly it was actually 6 bullets since I was using blood bullets, but you know. It was good. It was good resource management. All right, come on, buddy. Do the jump attack. Please do the jump attack. Let's try something. I want to try just, instead of trying to parry, just do the dual wield. See how far we can get. No heal, no bullets, just dual wield. Just Rikuya. Of course, this means no charge attack, which means I can't take advantage of any momentary weakness where he's stopped. But, we'll see how this runs. Come on, buddy, do that jump attack. I like it. I like the jump attack. Good one, trying not to be fancy. I'm gonna go back to trying to be fancy this time. Try to get those parries and backstabs. Nice backstab would be great to get. Gotta bait out that that ranged AoE. I could just stand here, I think. There he is. He knows me now. Okay, if I really want to get good here, I have to just literally just limit myself to only parries and backstabs. If I really want to approach it that way, then I need to do that. take this seriously? Shall we actually, No, I still haven't gotten good. I'm still not getting consistent parries. A lot of that's because I'm not surviving long enough to get consistent parries. But, you know. I feel like I'm getting better at it. Forward to Dark Souls 3. Kind of just, like, I could probably beat this boss a lot quicker if I, you know, if I went to, if I went to lengths, if I actually used resources, I probably could beat this boss, but I'm honestly killing time here. I'm trying to eat away the day, you know? Just hoping that Dark Souls 3... You know, it's 20 days out. 20 days out for me. You coming? You coming? Come on. Come on, buddy. Come on. Come on. There we go. Well, that didn't work. Animation canceled. Just keep practicing, just keep trying to get good. Because all of this, all of these attempts, all the things I'm learning, it's free. This is free. See, look at that. I can nail that parry quite often now. Hey buddy, you wanna come? There we go. Alright, getting those chain parries in. See, this is what I like to see. And I'm dead. Alright, just a little more practice. I don't know how much more practice. I've been doing this for about 30 minutes. It's not going to seem like that in the video because I'm going to edit it. I might even edit this part out. But I'm definitely getting more consistent with the parries. So, if I can chain parry him down to phase 2, then I'll start getting serious. I want to see if I can chain parry him down to phase 2. I'm just gonna be going for chain parries. That's it. That's the strat. That's my whole strat for this, is get the chain parry. Come on, buddy. Okay, that was bad. That was also bad. Simply not enough time to actually get a parry chain into backstab, unfortunately. And I think that's part of the reason why in addition to the charge to get the backstab, when you parry and visceral, you throw the enemy forward, because it makes it harder to get behind them and do a chain. No burritos here! That would've been good. Backstab. One of the nice things about Rikuyo is how quick it'll do a charge. And also the range on it. It's got some reach. At least I feel like it's pretty fast. Bad at going for the backstabs. Like, I haven't scored a single backstab. I've gotten a couple of parries, and that's been nice. I scored the parry, but not the visceral. That's happened to me a couple of times now. The thing is, it's still worth it to parry a juggle like that, even if it's a dirty parry, because that prevents the follow-up moves in the combo from hitting you and stun-locking you and juggling you, you know. So it's still worth it, it's just not as good as landing the full parry, you know? The atmosphere for this is just so cool, with the sunken ships and the sea out there and the shore. It's great. Okay, can't carry him out of that. Well, that sucked. Alright, gonna give it a couple more practice attempts. Try to get these parries down. The parries are really good at bullets, because there's just so many moves. This boss is really cool because, like, he can do animation cancels, which is something that is a PvP thing, but it's totally not, you know, it's almost, you know, people never program animation cancels on the AI. It's fucked up. But From did. They did. Programmed an animation cancel into a boss. It's pretty fucking cool. Ridiculous. Ridiculous. But, you know, that's how it goes. It's fine. It's better than, like, being in the middle of a rhythm with a boss fight and having to go and fucking farm out blood vials and shit. Like, I've got tons of blood vials and bullets right now. I'm pretty set. And I haven't used any, despite the fact that I've been spending an entire hour making attempts. Well, okay, I've used two. Despite the fact that I've made an entire hour of attempts on this boss. And yeah, they haven't been very successful attempts because I have literally not healed. Well, that sucked. Yeah. or two more parry attempts, and then I'm gonna switch to, I'm still not gonna be using heals, but I'm gonna switch to, dual wield, and stick by that for a while. Last attempt trying to be the gunslinger, trying to parry the world. Last attempt trying to do this way, and then we're gonna switch to dual wielding. And you know what? I'm gonna go ham on the bullets this time. So looked it up, apparently the Orphan is more vulnerable to fire than lightning, which makes sense since it has lightning attacks. So all that bolt paper I bought was actually not a good idea. Alright, we're gonna try dual wield strats now. I don't know how long I'm gonna... Well, I'm not gonna spend as long. Probably gonna end up doing more damage because it's more situational, which means I'm probably gonna get to phase two and start using resources. Which means, you know, it's probably not gonna be as long. R2s, the Repudio, are actually really quick. They're just as quick as the R1s, so... Or at least in transform mode they are. Bad dodge. Come on. How did that hit? I think a few more attempts, a few more tries with the dual wield strats, and then we're gonna start taking this seriously. Attempts failing to reach second phase, and we'll start to actually fight. Last try before I start actually fighting. Let's do this. The shooty-shooty and the dual-wieldy strats, and we're actually going to potentially heal, and we're actually going to be using bullets, so, yeah. Absolutely 100% not summoning for this fight. There's two fights in the DLC I would never summon for. Lady Maria, and this one. If Living Failures had been anything other than a joke, I would have been okay with summoning for that. Ludwig and Lawrence, obviously I was okay with summoning for that, but Orphan, and especially Maria, I would never summon. Let's just win the fight. I'm gonna win the fight this time, right? I'm gonna win the fight. He only knocked me back. Halfway between sort of like the two main modes of boss fight in Bloodborne, which are the hunter duel and the monster. And it's kind of halfway between the two main types of fight. Buddy, you can show me phase two again, right? You can show me phase two? Show me phase two. Damn it. Too late. out of blood vials. I got to second phase again. That's the good news. Come on, buddy. You wanna get chain parried? You wanna get chain parried? I thought so. But wait. It's not over. Because now, there's something over here. Let's take a look at this. What in the dick? What is this? Huh? What is this? I don't know what it is, but I think we should kill it.
Sweet child of Kos returns to the ocean. A bottomless curse, a bottomless sea, accepting of all that there is and can be.
And that is the final boss of the Old Hunters DLC. Oh look, there's my blood echoes over there. My non-existent blood echoes, because I didn't have any blood echoes. Almost 178k blood echoes from New Game Plus Orphan of Kos. Would you look at that? That's pretty. It's pretty. But I believe there's one more thing left. Actually, I want to go and look at these people. These fish ladies. Hey, fish ladies, what's up? Are you still... They're still praying. They're still praying to Kos. They weren't praying to the orphan, they were praying to Kos. And now the Hunter's Nightmare isn't fucked up anymore. I mean, it doesn't have, like, the fucked up sun. It's got, like, a clear sky. Or at least this portion of it does. Which is interesting. Let's go see how many blood vials that took. It didn't take that many, because I spent so much time practicing. Alright, let's talk to Doll, see if she has anything to say.
Oh, good hunter. I can hear German sleeping. On any other night, he'd be restless. But on this night, he sounds so very calm. Perhaps something has eased his suffering. Farewell, good hunter. May you find your worth in the waking world.
So yeah, Dahl says that Garamond is sleeping soundly now. Right? Okay. Let's see. Is he over here? Is Garamond anywhere? Nah, it's just the doll telling us stuff, so, okay. I really wish I'd gotten the dialogue for when you kill Lady Maria, from Doll, but I didn't realize that it was, like, so time-sensitive. Like, it's super time-sensitive, and I didn't get it, and now it's gone. Until I play another game. Until I go through the DLC again, and I really don't want to. Because fuck, man, it's tough. Like, I mean, I suppose I could go do a whole new game playthrough, and go through the DLC again, and get the dialogue, but that would be a pain. And besides which, Dark Souls 3 is coming out really soon, so I'm just, you know, I'm looking forward to that, honestly. So, yeah. Anyway. Anyway, I think this is going to be closing out my Bloodborne videos. I don't think I'm going to be making any more Bloodborne videos because it's less than 3 weeks until Dark Souls 3 comes out. And, you know, then I'm going to be focused on Dark Souls 3, honestly. However, I may do some, I may stream some Bloodborne. So, you know, if you're interested in that, you know, you can go to my Twitch channel and, you know, whatnot, and watch that. But I'm probably not going to be making any more videos for YouTube for Bloodborne. So, with that, I, So with that, thank you so much for watching, and if you enjoyed my videos, I really appreciate it. I appreciate all the comments I've gotten, any, you know, likes or subscriptions, all that. Really love it, and thank you so much for just watching me be terrible at video games. So that's a wrap on Bloodborne. Thank all of you so much. Later, internet.